What is going on, Rocket Powered Sound Designers? I'm Shane from Rocket Powered Sound. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at Chodegang. And this is a bass that I made that's kind of in their style. This is what it sounds like. So, really cool sound here. If you guys like that sound, you already know what to do. Drop a like, and if you're not already subscribed, click that subscribe button. We got weekly Serum tutorials coming out all the time, and you're missing out if you're not already subscribed. By the way, if you're not already on our Growlify early access list, link is down below if you're wondering what that is. But we're releasing a growl plugin Friday, the first ever growl plugin ever made on the internet, and it is insane. It turns any sound into a growl bass. So if you guys wanted to get on the early access to the plugin, because only the first 500 downloaders are able to get all these free bonuses, like free growl samples and stuff. So if you want to be one of the first 500 downloaders, I highly encourage you guys clicking that link below so you don't miss out on such crazy bonuses, because I'm just giving you guys free shit like always, because I love you guys. Let's get right back into the sound. Very cool sound here, guys, but we are modulating a lot of stuff, okay? So bear with me, we're gonna get through this together, okay? I know it can be a little bit difficult sometimes, modulating 8 things inside of a Serum. It's all cool. I'll be your guide for this tour, okay? Tour to the sound design jungle, eh? Okay, so first things first, we're gonna go into our spectral folder of our waveforms, and we're gonna select our Monster 5, okay? Okay, not too special here, just a growly waveform. We're actually gonna be dropping it around the 206th waveform here. And what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be modulating this using FM, frequency modulation. Haha, every single tutorial ever. So, we're gonna not touch the FM yet because oscillator B is not turned on. But what we are going to do is we're going to turn up the amount of voices, because it's not Riddim if we don't have 16 voices or more than 3 voices in general. And what we're gonna be doing to create that Riddim effect is we're gonna be dropping down the random phase. But this is what it sounds like for now. Just kind of a gross sound, but we're gonna drop down the random phase, and now let's hear what it sounds like. Oh my gosh, every Riddim sound ever. Now this is very key to making Riddim sounds. So we're gonna be dropping the detune down. And believe it or not, we're actually gonna be modulating the detune. Ready? It could create some really cool things. But before we do that, let's just kind of create the general shape of this sound that we wanna make, okay? So this is what I did in the original, the OG. We're gonna be doing a little something like this. It's completely up to you what you guys wanna do, up to your imagination. So I did a little something just like that. Put that on trigger, 1/4 is fine. And what we are also gonna do is modulate the detune, like I previously said. I really like the effect that modulating the detune does on the sound. It's a really cool trick. It can make some really unique combinations on your basses, and that's totally what you want, right? You don't wanna be generic, like Dubstep Gutter. No, I'm kidding, I love Dubstep Gutter. But you know, some of the songs start to, you know, get a little repetitive once in a while. Yeah, if you guys are wondering what the random phase does, it's basically concentrating, so instead of starting each one of these voices at a random spot, as you can see, the entire waveform selected, it's gonna start these all at a random spot within the highlighted area. And the more we turn down the random phase, the slimmer we make that area. So it's kind of choosing a spot, or it's really narrowing down the spot that it has available to start each one of these voices at. So once we put it down to 0 here, they're all starting at just about the same point, and that's what creates that really weird like bullet tone. Okay, let's get into our modulation. And what we're gonna be doing is turning on oscillator B, because we can't run frequency modulation without a second oscillator. And we're gonna drop the level down, because we don't need that level turned on since we are outputting all the sound through oscillator A. We're gonna be going into our basic shapes. Okay, I know usually what we're doing here is we're running frequency modulation off of a basic shape because the waveforms are so simple, you know, it's really easy to intercept a lot of complex frequencies off of. But we're actually going to be doing the opposite, and it creates some cool effects here. We're going to turn on, not FM, we're going to turn on our sync for our warp mode. And guys, I don't know if you saw in the beginning for the demo, I was changing back and forth this knob, the macro, and the macro was just turned on to the wavetail position, and it was swapping between a sine waveform right here and a sawtooth waveform. You know, it's completely up to you, but I like the way the sawtooth waveform sounds better, so I'm going to leave it there for this tutorial. And before we start turning up the sync, the voices, or anything else, we're going to turn up the octave. We're going to turn this up 3. Obviously, you can't hear anything because there's no frequency modulation that's being turned on. So what do you say we turn that up a little bit? What does that sound like? Oh, that sounds like a song. I don't want to stall you guys, but... can't remember. It's a song that was definitely on Dubstep Gutter. I can tell you that much. But, anyways, back to the tutorial. I love Dubstep Gutter, by the way. I don't know if I keep saying that. It's just like, I'm not dissing them. I love the fucking music there. It's great. We're going to turn on our FM from B. And we're going to turn it up just a tad bit. Get a little bit of movement there on the FM. Fuck, it's driving me insane. I don't know what song that is. If you guys know what song it is, comment down below. I know the song and then blah, blah, what it's called, okay? Don't just like drop the name in the title because a lot of the times I just skip over those because they're just people requesting for a sound. If you guys want to request a sound, drop it right into the submission box on our website, rocketpiratesound.com/tutorial-requests, okay? Back to the sound. Since we do have 16 voices turned on for oscillator A, we want to do the same for oscillator B. That way we can get the full effect here. We do want to turn on the random phase as well on oscillator B. And turn on the detune to just about the same spot. But we're actually not going to be modulating the detune. We're just going to be letting oscillator A handle that. And it's going to create just a really cool sound for the most part. Wait, let's turn that off for a sec. It takes away that whole skimmy sound. I don't even know how to describe it. But back to the sound, we are just going to turn up the sync. And this is really what's going to create that screechy effect. We're going to be modulating the sync up. Okay. Sounds entirely not good. But stick with me, guys. I keep saying that. We're going to be making something insane. We're going to be making Chodegang, okay? Chodegang doesn't just half-ass their stuff here, okay? It starts off a little bit bad, and then it creates something so heavy, and it's just beautiful, okay? So we want to be like Chodegang, right? Okay, so we're going to get into our miscellaneous section on our filter, and we're going to select our band reject. Okay, let's take a listen to what this sounds like. Okay, I don't hear anything, Shane. What's the deal with that? Let's try turning up the width a little bit. Still think you don't hear anything? I don't think so. We're going to be modulating the cutoff up. And that's going to create like a squelchy, squeezing, wet sound. Also, we need to turn up the resonance. And the width is also going to be modulating up. So band rejects are really cool filters. Okay, let's modulate this resonance down a little bit. Okay. Yep, that's working fine for now. Let's go straight into our effects section now. First things first on the list, we got a combs filter. Combs, I know. One of my favorite filters for sure in Serum. We're gonna be modulating the cutoff down, but first things first, let's just take a listen, get a grip on the combs. Sounds like Zeta and Dead Critic. Shout out Dead Critic and Zeta. I love those boys. Game Boy. A little bit. But, you know, same kind of style there. We're going to be modulating the combs filter down. Turn up the drive. Now we are starting to talk, okay? We're going to turn up our compressor, or turn on, not turn up. Turn up, baby. And we're going to be turning on our multiband, okay? Multiband's great. We're going to be smoothing out and evening out all these frequencies. Now we are really starting to get towards that sound that I originally started with. Without the filter, gross. Perfect. Oh my gosh. We are just loving the sound right now. I'm going to turn on our hyper amp dimension. Turn on the mix a little bit on the hyper. And the dimension size goes down to about 2%, 3%, 1%, nothing more than 5%. And we're going to be turning up that mix. If you're new here, the reason we don't turn on anything more than 5% is let's just turn it up all the way. Oh my gosh, that is nasty. So we're going to turn that down to about like 2%. 2% in DAX, baby. Sorry, I was singing a song. I don't know why I just turned on the EQ, because we're not using the EQ. We're going to be using our reverb. And to add the final touch, we're going to just type in rocket-powered sound. Also, speaking of rocket-powered sound, if you guys are wondering where the rocket-powered sound designer skin came in, because believe it or not, you're following along with this tutorial, so you are a rocket-powered sound designer. You are the next breed of sound designers. You are the future of the dubstep scene, or the EDM scene. I shouldn't say just dubstep, because I make all sorts of different genres. But yeah, you guys are the next breed of the sound designers. We are literally a movement. So if you guys are part of it, which I'm sure you are, if you're watching this tutorial this far into it, make sure you guys download that skin. It's at the bottom of the description, every description now. So you guys can just download that. And yeah, that's going to wrap up today's video. If you guys aren't already on the Growlify early access list, you guys are seriously missing out, because I'm only giving away 500 downloads of the bonuses. Like I said, guys, I'm not kidding. This is no joking matter. This is the first growl plugin ever created, and it's dope. So you're also going to be able to get an opportunity to check that out on that site. But I'm done rambling for this video. I'm Shane from Rocket Powered Sound. You know who I am. And I will catch you guys in the next video.